The song we just sang is called "The Rivers Are Running Again."
It is a celebration of spring and joy, and all the joys and rebirth that come with the warming temperature.
As the lyrics say, "Oh, spring has returned with the bursting of blossoms, with dancing and singing and days full of sun."
Hopefully, we'll get to experience the spring we sing about soon. I'm not sure it exists, but I'll continue to hope.
The next song we will be singing is called "Starlight."
It combines the traditions of Tanabata, the Japanese Star Festival, and the words from "Twinkle Twinkle Little Star."
The lyrics translate to bamboo grass leaves flowing in the wind, swinging by the edge of the eaves. Stars are shining like the fine gold and silver sand.
We are proud to present "Starlight."
Thank you.
Happier is a popular song on the radio today.
Fun fact, it is called Happier, but it is in fact a breakup song.
Did you just say fun fact?
Yes, I did.
You know what that means? It's time for the choirs to switch.
We will be filling this time with 10 fun facts.
10 random fun facts.
Number one, Cap'n Crunch's full name is Radio McGowan Crunch.
Number two, ketchup was sold in the 1830s as medicine.
Number three, almost is the longest word in English with all the letters in alphabetical order.
It actually takes 142.18 licks to reach the center of a Tootsie Pop.
Number five, it is impossible to sneeze with your eyes open.
Number six, a duck's quack doesn't echo, and nobody can figure out why.
Number seven, because metal was scarce, the Oscars given out during World War II were made of wood.
Number eight, it is estimated that millions of trees are planted by forgetful squirrels that buried their nuts.
Number nine, more Monopoly money is printed each year than real U.S. currency money.
And this has been number 10. The Guinness Book of Records holds the record for being the book most often stolen from public libraries.
And this has been 10 Fun Facts with Carter and James.
The middle school choir should be ready for the next part of our concert.
So without further ado, here's the middle school choir.
Thank you.
into a home for the poor and homeless.
I want to become a great pianist.
I want to live in a happy and peaceful world where people are blind to racism, sexism, and poverty.
Thank you.
Hold on a moment.
Good evening, it's good to see you all here. Before we sing our last two songs, there's just a few people that Mr. Gore and I would like to thank. First, thank you all for being here tonight to support the Milburn Choir program. We've got a good number of sick kids that are actually at home right now, so you're not seeing the full choir. All in all, we have about 90, 95 kids in choir, which is a significant amount of growth over the past 2 years, so we're very excited about that. We might have to consider over the next few years, if we keep growing, to be in a different space, because as you can see, we're pretty much full. But that's a good problem to have. Parents, thank you specifically for everything that you do to support these students so that they can participate in choir. I know the middle school students have had a good number of events over the past few weeks, one of which was the NIMCON Organization Contest, which we placed first division in this past Saturday. And that was with 20 students missing because they were sick. So that was pretty cool as well. So you guys rock, good job. Students, thank you for your hard work in preparation for this concert. I know it's a lot of fun for us as teachers to see the growth from your first time that you look at the song to where we are now. I know it's weird. And middle school students, prepare yourselves to start the process all over again tomorrow in class for the next concert. Yeah, I know, right? Mr. Gore and I would also like to thank the Milburn administration for their continual support of the performing arts, not only choir, but drama and band as well. It's a really great thing to be working in a district in which the performing arts are so highly valued. So Dr. Lind, Mr. Walsh, Mr. Jorgensen, thank you for everything you do. And lastly, I'd just like to thank everyone who participated in the choir t-shirt sale, either by purchasing t-shirts or sweatshirts, or by donating. We were able to raise $360 as a result of that for the choir program, which is helpful for purchasing various items that we need. So thank you everyone who participated in that. It was a lot of fun to see students. It's a lot of fun to see students with their t-shirts and sweatshirts coming around school with all of that. That is all I have to say. Again, thank you for being here tonight and supporting the choir program. Enjoy our last two pieces and have a great rest of your night and a great spring break coming up in a couple of days.
The tragic results of prejudice and hate toward other people, but it is also a reminder that hope held firm will eventually reign victorious over the greatest of odds. The following words were inscribed on the walls in the southern Cologne, Germany, where Jews were hiding from the Nazis during World War II. Hope was all they had to hold on to. Hope was their only bridge to a brighter tomorrow.
I believe in God.
called Description of Hope.
The author of the lyrics is unknown. What is known is that these words were found carved in a cellar wall in Cologne, Germany.
It was during World War II that these Nazis' words were written. Most likely by a Jewish refugee hiding from the Nazis.
The prevailing theme is hope, with the song ending with the lyrics, "May there someday be sunshine, may there someday be happiness, may there someday be love, may there someday be peace."
The final song we'll be singing is one of the most well-known and loved songs by the band Queen.
Don't Stop Me Now is a song about enjoying life to the fullest and living in the moment in every moment.
Please enjoy Don't Stop Me Now.